Welcome back, trainers, and we have the official information for Litwick Community Day, as we were kind of predicting. I mean, all of us were. We saw it coming down the pike here. And the nice thing is it's going to be introduced shiny for its Community Day. Let's go. And it's a useful Pokemon. It's going to be learning Poltergeist. And we'll get more into that here in a minute. So it is going to be on October 15th from 2 p.m. until 5 p.m. local time. Folks, let's go. Freaking Litwick Community Day. Learning Poltergeist is going to be doing damage of 140 in PvE and PvP. That's going to be crazy. We don't have all the information regarding the energy, but it is looking pretty interesting here. So folks, get ready. We're going to be getting times 3 XP for catching, if that's something you're looking for. And then, of course, 3-hour incense and lures. Now, it is going to require a Unova Stone, so start collecting those, and I'm assuming they're going to release all kinds of tasks to get those easier. Looking at the bonuses, as we usually do get the times 2 candy for catching, and then the XL candy, if you're of the level to get those, you're going to be able to do an extra special trade, and then 50% reduction in trades as well. Take a snapshot for 5 Litwicks. Make sure you do that. This is definitely something you want to get as many as you can. Poke, what happened? You didn't go live for the last Community Day. Gigalith, what happened? I'll tell you about it here in a moment. 99 cents ticket, which, look, I don't know who's out here watching these videos when people are making it. Like, is it worth it? It's 99 cents. You're going to waste 10 minutes of your life to see if it's worth it? It's just good. It's just get it. It's good. Taking a look at the rates. Oh boy, let's talk about this. Now, we'll get into why I didn't go live here in a bit. But you're going to be seeing Lampet, which is going to be Fire and Ghost, so it's not going to have a specific double weakness, so you're going to, yet again, have to have two people. So they're going to be spawning around there for 30 minutes afterwards from 2 until 10 p.m., which is awesome. That's a long time. But here's the thing. Ever since these little raid deals came out, Niantic has introduced them. It's always broken. They're either spawning before the raid boss is even beat, or they're just not even spawning at all. So I don't know. Hopefully they can get it together and actually have them spawn, because this is going to be fun and I'm going to be out here for a long time. Taking a look at the top ghost types, Gengar. Mega Bayonet. Shadow Bayonet. Mega Gengar. Let's go ahead and take a look at page 2. So Chandelure is going to be the second one with Hex and Shadow Ball. So Poltergeist is going to be a lot stronger. We don't know the energy, we don't know the effects. In the main series games, it has something to do with items, held items on your opponent. So it's kind of way out of the realms of anything happening in Pokemon Go, so we'll just see what they do with it. All we know at this point is it's very strong. I do believe it'll be pushing it up. I mean, hopefully. So taking a look at all the bonuses, you're going to be getting, again, 3 times catch XP. So if you're trying to level up, now's the time to turn on those lucky eggs and go to town. So the only thing that is going to be carrying over from the raids is going to be the trading. So don't get too excited for all those other things. Yeah, it'd be nice if they allowed them to go all the way through, but whatever, I'm not going to complain about it. Stardust is where it's at, if that's what it was. As far as XP, you know, I'm already stacked up. So taking a look at the move again, 140 in trainer battles, in gyms, and raids, it's going to be 140 as well. So I just wanted to show you what the image does look like in the main series games. I did get it mixed up with an actual Pokemon. It's not quite the same name. I was quite quickly corrected on Twitter, so deleted that. So when it comes down to the move itself, what we can expect to see are these kind of like ghost spirit things moving in towards the Pokemon. So it should probably be a pretty cool little animation when we do get it. Awesome. Taking a look at my Rock and Roll Up results. So what happened? Why didn't I go live? Look, you know what happened? Folks, ever since I went to Vegas, it released the beast in me. Hanging out with those girls, I was just like, I just been on a roll with them lately. So yeah, hung out with somebody and I just said, I'll turn on an incense. Whoop. So I just need a break, man. I'm not trying to drive around and do all that for this kind of weak Community Day. I didn't want to bring it down in my videos or say anything like that. I said it was kind of a chill Community Day, but it was still something that a lot of people should have went out there and done if you didn't have, you know, a lot of good rock type attackers. Simple as that. I mean, there's nothing crazy to it. And that's all. All right, I can get into details, but we'll just leave it at that. That's what I was doing. Took a little bit of a break. My Litwicks. Oh, and I forgot to evolve my 98 freaking Rock and Roller. Yay! That I had saved up. I don't think I'm using an Elite TM on that crap. And I do have some videos on it, so make sure you have your notifications on. Taking a look at my Litwick Chandelure collection here, got a 98 and one that looks like it's good for PvP, so we'll just hold on to those and evolve them. I do have one called Grim and Reaper. Hope you like that. That's a little bit of a fun play there. Taking a look at what Chandelure is currently doing in Go Battle League. All right, so let's go ahead and match up against Medicham. Why the hell is a ghost losing to Medicham? Okay, so it baited us and then hit us with Psychic. All right, let's go ahead and change Incinerate to Hex here. See what that's going to do for it. If it's going to actually, you know, able it to win this matchup, you know, a ghost type up against a fighter. And there we go, winning that matchup. But what's going to happen is when you do this, it is going to flip all the other matches, and you're going to lose other matches because now you don't have Incinerate. You're not going to be doing as much up against those steel types, grass, whatever the case may be. Going up against Registeel or losing that with Hex, you're winning it with Incinerate, but really circumstantial energy and all that. But I just want to go through the motions here to show you all. Up against Skarmory, we are winning that with Hex. Okay, and looking good. All right. But when you move into the Ultra League, let me show you a little something here. When you start seeing losses at a 100 in the 100s, that is something that you probably don't really want to use too much. I mean, it does have some hard wins. Let's not get it twisted. That's for sure. It's going to be good up against some things. But that's granted, you get those alignments and it allows you to even go up against those Pokemon. You put a freaking fire up front, all you're going to see is water. Go watch my last video. This stuff is nonsense, folks. It's crazy. But I just wanted to do a few simulations here and kind of give you an idea. You know, there's not just one moveset that's going to be good. It has multiple different good movesets. And it has Shadow Ball and Flame Charge already. This thing is already stacked. I mean, it's on the chart for being one of the top raid attackers for a lot of bosses when it comes down to them being weak to fire or ghosts. So you're looking at a great Pokemon here. This move is just going to put it on the map even more. If you did enjoy my video, give it a thumbs up. Let's get ready. October is going to be quite lit. Take care, traders.
Hey! So you're finally here! Fantastic!